mad.
It's sounding great.
Bloody amazing. So what we've got here is Jason Tong is actually a cameraman today. He's behind the camera. I'll film him in a moment. He's brought over his new ALTA. What do we call it? Version 2?
Well, version 2, because I think version 1 I bought here.
Show them. ALTA version 2, which has got more channels than you can throw a stick at. Three channels, actually. But they both have vintage and modern modes, and there's a set of different bright switches and all this sort of groovy stuff that you can switch on and off via MIDI.
That's right.
Is that right?
Yep. So you could hook it up to a simple MIDI foot switch, like a Morningstar MC8 or something like that.
This is Jason, everybody.
Hey, nice. Yeah. Nice to see you. Or I actually run this, I've been using this quite frequently with an AX FM3.
Yep.
And I can run it in four cable methods, so I can put effects in front and obviously through the loop.
Yep.
But importantly, I've got the MIDI out from the FM3 running into this, so that any combination of channel 1, 2, 3 and the voicing options that are available, I can actually have switch in and out with scene changes on the FM3. So it's pretty flexible. The thought process behind the kind of having all this MIDI control was to apply the concepts that we see in gear like the AX,
yeah,
but apply it to a tube amp.
Yeah, you can kind of have so you've got the marriage of old and new, really, but yeah, with the current
modern
switching technology.
But the old analog tube path.
That's ace. And I suppose I'll just give this camera back to you because I'll show them what's going on as far as the signal path goes for our little cameo appearance. We have the ALTA running directly to, God, where's it coming? Into input 2 here via this guy here. So the 8-ohm speaker output from the ALTA is going to the X-load, and the X-load is going into input 2 here. We did have this in there as well, but we're having groundwork problems, so we're just going straight into input 2, and it just sounds rock. The heaviest channel, is it?
That's channel 2, and we're in the kind of vintage mode. Vintage meaning vintage voicing, so it's a bit less gain. It's got a bit more guts in the bottom end.
Yeah.
You know?
We have to show them.
So
that's vintage. That's channel 2, vintage mode.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you play a few... Actually, maybe I'll...
I'm holding the camera.
Holding the camera and the guitar. Give me the guitar.
Oh, we got the have the fancy one.
Right, so let me just play some basic stuff. So,
yeah. Turn the delay off there for that.
Okay. So we've got bright voicing switches here, right? So they work independently. So you have them off and it's a bit darker. You can have one on. Both on. But in vintage voicing, you kind of got that, you know, 70s sound that's a bit more broad and bottom, a bit more bass in the bottom end. A
bit more manly.
A bit more manly, great rhythm sound.
No neck tattoos and perms here.
That's correct.
With all due respect to
my... can't play like that either. when we go to modern, it tightens up the bottom end and there's more gain, right? So here's vintage again. And if you're looking for a bit more saturation and compression, we've got a clipping function in here, which is kind of carried over from the Kelly amp, which Brett has featured on the channel, and that's still sitting over there. Brett actually owns Serial 001.
Well, you've got the orange guitar. What more do you want?
I do have the orange guitar.
We have to get Kelly. We have to arc Kelly up again soon,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, we will. So we can bring that in. We've got a second master volume on the rear of the amp, so we can compensate for the volume drop that you get with diodes.
With extra saturation.
Still in channel 2 here, right? But this is kind of you're seeking the kind of the brown sounds. do that all day.
The sound of rock!
It is. If you go to channel 3, we'll give that a go, right? Channel 3 is builds on 2, so it's not a whole different voicing, it's just kind of like...
Four.
Yeah, it's a gain stage out in front, so
okay.
The idea with 3 is to kind of avoid the need to put boost pedals and all that kind of stuff. I mean, you can, obviously, so yeah. If you want to put your favourite tube screamer or whatever, but this thing will just really starts to fatten up what's available in channel 2, so if you're really after those... Again, I'm back in vintage voicing here, but with the channel 3 mode, big, heavy, bold rhythm sounds. Flip back to 2, you can hear the difference. And if you go into the modern voicing, I'll bring the brights kind of back a bit. We're really into kind of much, this is pretty high gain kind of territory now, right?
Try that one.
what
fun. My turn. I didn't mean that about neck tattoos and perms either, by the way.
You're thick, man.
Punch.
Killer.
I did the delay. Oh, we should tell them what cab we're running. It's just a greenback mix. Look, it says greenback mix. So nothing really, you know, fancy happening there. Let's just turn on, whoops, turned him off. We'll turn on that Friedman ML. Oh, God's sake, Kingman, get it together.
The Friedman's a bit, yeah, angry.
Remarkable piece of engineering. Jason Tong.
Thank you, sir.
Now, I'm going to go back to watching you now because we can buy these now, can't we?
Yeah, these for sale. So you can check out on the website, headfirstamplification.com. You can also go to my YouTube channel, Headfirst Amplification. There's a bunch of demos of this. And I go through kind of all the features and functions at a fairly in-depth level. But if you go to the website, you'll see I've got a whole page dedicated to this where I talk about how you can get one. And you can email me at headfirst.amplification@gmail.com or send me a message through the website or go onto my Facebook page, Headfirst Amplification.
And say hello.
Yeah.
Now, these are available in the US as well, right?
Yes, that's right. So I'm working with my partner, Shay, who is the guy behind Monomyth. Amplification. So if you haven't heard of Monomyth, I suggest you check it out, especially if you're into kind of high gain modded Marshalls. So I've been working with Shay for a little while now. I helped him out with some printed circuit board design stuff for his own line of amps.
Yep.
And he's helping me out now in terms of making these available in the US. So he's building these in his workshop in Indiana, and we're selling directly into the US market via that channel.
Well, that worked out well.
Yeah, so that's been fantastic, right? So we can get them made in Australia, and we're getting them made in the US, and they're identical amps, right down to the very last detail, the same head cabs, everything's the same.
Rockin' friggin' roll.
Yeah.
That's great.
It's got a clean channel too, right? But
oh, do we want to hear that?
I don't know.
Yeah, of course we do.
You want to give it a go?
Yeah, you'll have to dial it in for
me. All right, I'll dial it in. So channel one here, guys, is kind of, this is where we get into, you know, it's meant to be kind of more of a vintage kind of plexi style setup. And channel one over here has its own gain, EQ and volume setup. Beautiful and polite. You know what? I don't know that people are going to be buying it just for the clean channel, though. But you couldn't blame them if they did.
Yeah.
But it's... sure offers a lot, because that'll actually go into plexi territory, won't it? Clean channel, rock and roll. Headfirst Amplification, headfirstamplification.com or headfirst?
Yeah, yep, that's it.
Headfirstamplification.com. Goodbye, Jason Tong.
See you guys. Isn't he a great bloke?
Thanks, Brett.
See you soon.
Cheers, buddy.